Make Kellogg's Product 19 your common sense cereal.
Yankees have been picked for the All-Star team. Jerry Girard has that story and a report on tonight's action at Shea Stadium. Jerry is a little sad this evening, and it's
so
affected us, too. Jerry, you want to pick up the action news?
Joe, don't repeat that intro. We'll be 5 minutes over. The Yankees, where are those All-Stars tonight? I've been looking for them with binoculars. They're trailing 5-2 in the ninth. Backs to the wall, as usual, to the Minnesota Twins. Ray Corbin got help in the ninth inning. Ninth inning still going on. Pat Dobson started for the Yankees, got knocked out. One of the Yankee runs, Bobby Bonds, a home run. That's number 20 for him. Now, in Boston tonight, the Red Sox continue to win. They're leading. The game is not over. It's 7-3 Red Sox at Fenway over Texas in the seventh. It's Detroit 3, KC 2 in the seventh. Baltimore, California, a later start. In the National League, Pittsburgh beat Los Angeles 4-1. The Mets did not play, so they now trail 7.5 games behind Pittsburgh. Chicago beat San Diego 3-1. Montreal and Atlanta rained out. Speck Richardson has been fired as GM of the Houston Astros. A very sick franchise. They need help. Three Yankees, as Joe said, are on the All-Star team, and they all deserve it, really. A late rush of votes for Greg Nettles makes him the third baseman. Bobby Bonds got more votes than any other outfielder, and there was never any doubt that Thurman Munson would be the catcher. He's been hitting all year long, just like this. Driving in runs, getting those key hits, and no slumps, you know. I've been expecting this for a few years, and he finally developed, and it's beautiful to watch him in action. Now, Joe Rudy has been playing first base all year, so naturally the fans voted him into the outfield. He's going to be in the starting outfield, even though he doesn't play outfield. I can't follow all of this jazz. That's why the whole thing is a farce. Other A's on the team include Reggie Jackson, right here. He'll play either center or right. Bert Campaneros at short, and Gene Tennis at first. Rod Carew is the second baseman. We have no arguments there. American League looks strong, but continue to lose to the National League. The Knicks, who dreamed about starting George McGinnis at forward, will now have to figure a way to stop him. The next time the Knicks play Philadelphia, McGinnis will be in a 76er uniform. Big George signed for 6 years at about $500,000 a year. That will make Philadelphia real tough next year. As for the Knicks, who originally signed McGinnis, only to have the contract ripped up by the commissioner, only one consolation, they're getting back the $500,000 bonus they paid McGinnis. Compliments of Philadelphia. And by the way, if you're a Knick fan, don't get upset over this, because let me tell you a little bit about McGinnis. He was in a game a few years ago when the game was really all over about a minute to go. He comes in for a layup, misses the layup deliberately, then hits it up against the backboard 4 or 5 times to increase his rebound total. Now that is cheap, friends. Believe me, I don't want to get him mad because he is 6'8 and 245. One squeeze, that's all for Girard. Always big, born big, 6'1. He was born 6'1, went straight to work. They've gone 2 rounds of the British Open, and there's a new leader, David Hoosh of Scotland. He broke the course record with a 67 today to go 2 up on yesterday's leader, Peter Oosterhuis. Also 2 back is Tom Watson, had a good round today. He also shot a 67. Here he is trying for an eagle on the 14th. No good, but he gets his birdie as he taps it. And also tied with him are Cole, Oosthuizen, and Marshall. Ah, Jack Nicklaus. Looking for an eagle here on the 16th. He shot a 71. He is 3 strokes behind. Now, Jack on the 16th. We always whisper at golf tournaments, a lot of people sleeping. Jack, want to hit the ball, please? Jack, we have to go to work. Never mind, Jack. Jack? Is this a still frame? It's a slide. No, it isn't. Jack Nicklaus. We got exhausted watching you, Jack. Johnny Miller, Hale Irwin, and Jack Newton are tied with Nicklaus. Oh, boy. At the races at Yonkers tonight, CBA 3990 for a triple. The exact in the second race was bigger than the triple. DC 6720. At Belmont, it was B&J in the double 7260. And CGA in the triple 56420. In the feature, 6 horses for 6 furlongs. And 3 of them are headed for a photo finish.
Stretch, Petrograd on the outside. Native blend between horses, see the USA on the rail. It's Petrograd on the outside leading, see the USA on the inside. And here's the finish. Petrograd holds on and wins it by a nose.
Petrograd wins and pays $3.60. And that's the story in sports tonight.
And we should have the story on the weather in just a moment, but first we pause for these words.
Welcome to the Broadway Musical Show.